picture machine working correct this time?
Absolutely.
Why was
perfect.
It just pointing up?
It just points up.
You're just going to edit out that bright white blur?
There won't be a blur.
So DMX, that's what the theme song should be for this? We're going to put DMX in there?
I'll put some DMX in.
Which one? Like where he's preaching or the one where he's going to give it to you?
Give it to you.
Gonna give it to you. What? Fuck, wait for you to get it on your own. X gonna deliver to you. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real.
Yeah, like these hoes up in here. All right, we're gonna build this thing. See if you can figure out what it is. There's a left side and a right side to it. So a lot of times I'll build stuff and I'll end up with two lefts or two rights. Imagine my surprise. Or I'll end up with, it's kind of built correctly, but one side's on the wrong side. So that's always important. So I have a sample over here, but you guys can't see it yet. So we've built a lot of these in the last few weeks, and we've got more that we built yesterday. So I figured while we were doing that, we do one in Highlander. I don't think we've ever made one in Highlander, and I kind of thought like Highlander would probably show up on the camera well. So I've got parts of one built here already. I sewed the other day, and we'll go ahead and do that. And I did that so that I was more likely to not have two of one side. So we'll just start with kind of elimination right here, and we will go from there. Right? We'll go from there?
We'll go from there.
I don't know why I have that marked there. I hope I don't need that. Surely I don't. I don't know why I have two of those. That's kind of weird. In about 45 minutes, I'll be like, oh shit, that's why I have that. So something's going on here. The thread's pulling up. It's really puckering this. And it, zoom in on this right here. So that's all straight lined. And what that means is there's probably something going on in the bobbin. So if you look here, see, I can just grab a loop and it just pulls out. Let's pull it from, it just pulls right out. So let's grab a hold of, okay, so there's a loop of thread, right? I can literally just pull that out because it hasn't tensioned. That's what I mean with straight lined. It rips open kind of like a bag of dog food does. I mean, some of you are probably super un-American and have never had a dog, so you wouldn't know that. Or some of you are super bougie and you only feed your dogs canned dog food. Fucking weirdos. So let's re-thread that needle. I pulled the bobbin out already. Let's pull this up here. Let's see if this sews right. Yep. Your other option, if it's not the bobbin, it's usually that this thread is caught around that thread stand, which is why I have the bag on there. John, my thread didn't come with a bag. That's okay. You can use this any bag, a Ziploc bag. For some of you, I would get a smaller Ziploc bag that won't fit over your head so that you don't accidentally get trapped inside of it. But and pull it, so I just try to gang everything together and run it in, so that's what this here is. Get used to using thread nippers and you won't do this all the time, right? You won't have carpal tunnel, at least not as quickly. You'll still get it, but if you're going to do this for any length of time, you're going to get carpal tunnel. So, panel here. Which way did I make this one? Long way, short ways. I think it's this way. While I'm filling this edge, I want it nice and tight and crisp, so I'm kind of pulling on this here. And while I'm down here, I might as well travel back up the other side from the back to anyways. Man, there's nothing to clean up on some of this.
Be that good?
Yeah. Yeah. So what that is like you'll notice when I cut thread a lot of times, I'll put the work under the foot, whatever, and then pull on the other piece. And that it just tightens it up and gives you a much cleaner. Put this 2 inches down here. You really don't need to draw this line and connect it right like this, because you have a dot and dot. That's all you really need. You don't have to connect the lines whether you realize it or not. So that Velcro there, why is the line in the middle? Because we're going to attach other things to it, and I want this to be solid because you're putting pistol cards or something on this, and that's why I'm doing that, because I don't want them to have any give on there. That's why that line's there. This one does not have, I don't think we even put a line on the real product. Not really necessary. It's against the body, so it can't really pull anywhere anyways. But if you want to be like the one I built is better than SOE, you can put a line in there. You can be the extra line guy.
That's your sales tactic?
If you're like the cream of Semyon guy, you could be the extra line guy. What is this, 10? I bet those are 3.5. I bet they are 3.5. 3.25. Let's try this. Is it 3.25? 3.25. That leaves me 3.5. Nope. Let's try this again. All right, 3. And that leaves us what? 7. So it is 3.5. Okay. So there's a half. There's a half. That leaves us 3. Now, let's mirror this and make sure that it's opposite. There's three. That's seven, so 3.5. Ka-chow. Ooh, I already had them drawn out. We're not using the blue side, we're now using the red side. All right, let's get rid of some pieces here. This is 12 inches. You know the footprint of a 308 mag is about 3.5 inches. The footprint of a 556 mag is 3 inches. So if you build everything off of that, right? If I want a rig that is only mags and I want three mags across, that's 369, right? Okay, so that's 9 inches. Are we going to build the mag on top of the piece that has the buckles? So is that footprint going to be a solid 9 inches, or are we gonna make it 10 so we have room for edge tape? Or are we gonna fold our edges over like this so that we don't have to have edge tape? And where are the buckles gonna go? How much bulk do you wanna sew through? How many of these do you wanna build? In what manner do we wanna build them? Does the inch of difference make a difference, right? If we added an inch to this panel and an inch to this panel, instead of 9 inches and 18 inches, it's now 20 inches because half is 2 more inches, right? 20 inches. And then how are we closing it in the middle? Are we gonna use a zipper that's gonna give us about 1/2 inch to 3/4 inches extra? Or are we using buckles, right? And how wide are those buckles that we're using? I don't even know where the here's the buckles. How wide are the buckles, right? And if we say, well, the buckles are 2.5 inches, are they really 2.5 inches, or do we have to have some webbing there so we have some tail so that we actually have something to sew to? So that's kind of important, or maybe it's not at all important. You'll have to decide for you. Did any of that make sense? Somebody it made sense to, somebody it didn't, but one day what I just said will make sense to the guys that it didn't make sense to. That or they just quit, and then it doesn't matter. And then if you have these four pieces of webbing, right, I'm gonna make the same measurements, like those. You don't have to measure them all. Measure your first one. The first one becomes a gauge, and then just transfer your marks. It's a whole lot faster. And then we want this in the center, and this piece here happens to be 6, so the center of 6 is 3. Or the quarter is 3 of 12, right? So we're gonna go there and there. And I don't have to make marks on here because I already made the marks on here. Although I made them, you can't see them once they're on here, but you get the idea. Sew back through all of this a lot. I don't have to sew it down crazy. You'll see why in a second. Yep, I know. The other one I tacked in the middle. This one I didn't. I only tacked on the edges. And I didn't even sew down that edge. You'll see in a second. A lot of guys put so much thread in their shit, and they don't fucking have any clue why they do it. So we're gonna put Velcro over here. Why are we putting Velcro here, right? And why did we put Velcro here instead of this over? Because I don't want that mag inserting here to stutter on this edge right here. And for the most part, it wouldn't anyways, and it probably wouldn't matter, but the edge of a magazine will break the scab on that webbing eventually. And you'll have some crybaby that has gear because it looks neat and not because he really uses it, and he'll cry that the fuzz is coming off the edge. So we'll just conceal it right here with this piece of Velcro. I don't like no Velcro on my stuff. The commies will know. well, they probably know that that 20 rounds of 308 you just dumped, they might know you're there. Oh my God, John. He just sewed that and didn't sew a line through the middle of the 3-inch. Slow down. It's going to be okay. You'll see. Do you need me to slow down? Are you going too
quick? I was asking for you to slow down. If you could slow down to like
100 miles an hour, maybe
175 even would be good enough, at least for the viewer to see it.
If you're gonna make me jump out of the car, could you slow down to at least 65?
Yeah, I could do that for you.
All right. There's 3, there's 9. Man, I can't believe he marks this all up. We actually had people complaining about that. I'm like, rub it on your corduroy pants that your mom put on you from Oshkosh, because that's a colored pencil it'll wipe off. Probably. Let's go ahead and make these marks. Do they still make corduroy pants, or is that just like hippie chicks that wear those?
I don't know.
I'll bet most of these kids watching this don't even know what a hippie chick is.
Maybe, or corduroy pants. I still have some corduroys.
Do you?
Yeah. I'm in a dresser drawer at home.
Did you wear them in like the first grade?
No, skateboarding. They were really big in skateboarding.
Really?
And I feel like the knees were kind of worn, you know?
Yeah. So they were like a lot lighter color.
Yeah. I still have a couple pair of jeans that are button fly from Levi's.
These are not button fly. Alright, that's good. Just tuck these under. I'm gonna let this hang over, right? So this is your center line. This is gonna be pals right here. And the spacing's 3 inches for the most part, right? Did you hear that gunshot?
I heard it.
So we're gonna come over 1.5 inches right here. These are not 3 inches. These are like 3.5 or more, maybe even 4. So I'm just going to fold this because I want my stitch line to hit that 3-inch mark. So I'm hanging over probably a 16th inch. You'll see here in a second what I'm talking about, if you don't already know. And then I'm just going to use this as my gauge, as my spacer. You can use a piece of 1 inch or whatever. Especially if you're calling two bars of pals that you're doing, you're not going to have a lot of shift. It's not going to matter too much. If you're doing a bunch, you'd want to make sure that if you're off just a tiny bit and you're doing 10 rows of that shit, you know, it'll translate if you're off. But here's what I'm talking about. So the stitch line, the center's on center, and then I'm 1.5 inches over. So this column right here is 1.5 inches. And then here is the stitch line, but the material holds over a little. I don't want a raw edge right here. So I have folded it under. You do yours however you want. Whatever it is that you like, you do that. Now, when you're traveling off of there, this is obviously the way we make our pals. It, where it's folded on the end, I'm four layers of corduroy, so it's a little tall. So just make sure as you're crawling up on this, take a, you know, a needle strike, lift the tension off of there, put it in place. Now I've driven into the actual material that I'm tacking down, and then tack it down so you don't have shift, because that presser foot will shift that work. There's that. Now we're just going to duplicate the same thing three more times. And you don't have to do the center first. You can do the edges and then come over, or whichever way you're stronger, whether you can work left to right or right to left, whatever you want to do. A lot of times people will watch a video on how to do something, and then we try to emulate it over and over. And we never get to the best point for us as an individual, because why do you do it that way? Because that's the first way you saw it done, right? And then your grandmother showed you how to do it, and she showed grandkids how to do it, and it just keeps getting done that way, right? You can only make a peach cobbler if it's cast iron. Well, why do we use cast iron? Because that's, and really, when you get to the root of it, it's because that's how grandma used it. And really, you should probably be using cast iron anyways, because it's not poisoning you like most of the nonstick shit is. And if you're 13 watching this, I know that you don't give a shit. But if you make, and I know that you also think that you won't live to be 50 years old, but as a 52-year-old man, you know, I have a penis. If you don't have a penis, you're not a man. You can pretend, but as a 52-year-old man, you will then care about all of that shit. So get some stuff that's not nonstick. I think it's the dude a couple of properties over. I like it. I wish all of my neighbors shot every couple of days. Then thieves would be like, yeah, we don't want to fuck with nobody on that road.
I'm just gonna hook up my band's PA, put the speakers out in the trees, and just loop gunfire all day.
Why don't you just have real gunfire?
I live inside the city. Well,
yeah, but that's
city.
Is it really a city? I mean, no. That's like, those aren't laws. Those city are like limits. Kind of wishes.
Yeah, and people shoot at the stop sign in front of my house all the time.
Yeah,
I mean, that's right in front of the city cemetery.
Surely there's some real crime that your local law enforcement handle, like all those kids that are tipping over those farmers' cows and shit.
Yeah, and porta potties. That's a big thing.
They tip over porta potties
constantly.
Why, man?
I don't know.
They're just being a fucking little asshole. Okay, you want to tip over porta potties? We should take you, and when we capture you, right? When we find that the video footage of you or your phone shows that you were, we geofence you to the porta potty. Then we get to put you in the porta potty and just drive you around as fast as we can, right? And then you're going to be covered in blue stuff. How do I even know that the porta potty's blue? I guess because of videos I've seen, right? And then you have to clean it out by hand. You have to literally just wipe it out. right? We'll give you a sink of clean water, but you don't get to clean yourself off. You have to wipe the porta potty off. And then you get to spend a year cleaning porta potties for the porta potty company. I think that's fair, right? Because he obviously didn't have a job.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the year, we'll pay you a living wage, right? Not the living wage you think you need, the living wage of what you look like you should be paid. Obviously, you weren't concerned about a living wage when you were out tipping porta potties over.
It's a big thing.
Really?
In our town, it is. It's huge. Construction site, porta potty tip overs and stuff.
Man, we have a lot of porta potties here for weeks at a time. If I caught you fucking tipping over porta potties, I'd lock your ass in there.
Then tip it over.
I would. I'd leave you would live in the porta potty. Like I'd bring you out and feed
Strap
you.
Around it?
Yeah. I'd feed you and do, you know, take care of you and make sure that you're alive.
I would only feed you through the exit hole.
through the shit catcher.
Yeah, the shit dump.
I'll bet you'd get sick if you were locked in a porta potty in a length of time.
I peed in one the other day and almost threw up, so better just to pee outside.
I pee beside them. That's the beauty. Like when people will hear this and not understand, I just pee outside, right?
I pee outside almost daily, single day.
Because it's my property. I can pee wherever I want. I encourage it. I have my friends come over and we just pee places.
I live in city limits and just pee. I just pull up my car and just step outside and just pee.
In California, if you peed off your porch, they'd get you for like some pedophile charges or something. Some child sex charges.
I will say that Rachel does scream, you better not do that.
Like, you hear the horror stories of people that have pulled over on the side of the interstate, you know, so their kids can go to the bathroom and shit. What's going on over here? Something is not right. There we go. Super extra long tail. Let's get this started over here so it's winding right. I'll probably have to change the bobbin maybe two more times, maybe three, for this project to be done. Is this taking a long time? It seems like it's taking a long time.
I don't know. I'll find out when I'm editing.
I think I'm allergic to one of these guys on the video. Just listening. You probably know who you are. If you're if you got all your friends and you're not sure who that guy is, I'm gonna let you in on a secret. If you don't know who that guy is in your group, you're that guy. Also, probably the guy that I'm allergic to. People have cats and they're allergic to cats, but that guy, his cat's probably allergic to him. Same for your dog. Did you see my possums?
I did.
Did you see them? Did you see them in real life?
I haven't seen them, no.
Okay, so
three of them?
I only captured two.
Oh.
The other one's out there, or the dog might have ate it. Remember what we were smelling the other day?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what has happened.
Possum?
He got a hold of another possum, and I think that was the mom possum. And the babies were like in a den or in the debris in that giant wood pile. I'm gonna have to go talk to that neighbor. All that single shooting, man. He should really have something with higher capacity. I realize he's from the city, so he's probably testing out whether he can legally shoot or not to see if the cops show up.
Did they just ban guns somewhere, or Washington or something?
So you hear that all the time, right? And I would not be surprised at all if that's what happened. But a lot of times when you look into it, it's like, okay, we just passed this thing, but it didn't really go into effect, right? We passed it and now it's going to go to a vote, or we put it before, like,
put it before Congress, I mean, or something. Or?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, they just passed a thing to put to vote whether half of the fucking state is going to become its own state, like Washington and Oregon and Northern California and stuff. A lot of those cities, they're just fucking, a lot of them states. And who knows, right, what the real deal is? But it looks like those states are falling apart.
Just waiting for the UFO invasion.
Oh, I think it's coming. I mean, if you're not aware, you should look into Project Blue Beam. I think a lot of it is watch this and don't pay attention to us stealing 65% of every dollar you make for taxes. We have to get people to fight amongst themselves so that they don't pull us from the castle and eat us.
I'm hoping aliens will do that.
Eat the political parasites?
Yeah. I'm hoping aliens will just eat everybody almost.
Everyone? Everyone? I don't want to be eaten by an alien.
Well, not you. I mean, we'll be okay. I have a feeling they'll just look at you and, like, they'll go, ah, oh, he's not bad. Let's just go to the next one. You know what I mean? Like, that's what I feel like about me. I'm going to, like...
He'll sniff you and be like, yeah. You smell too much like formaldehyde.
Yeah, you're okay.
What's
Get out of here.
What does tattoo ink smell like? What's that awesome tattoo ink? Didn't it have formaldehyde in it? That's why it was so vibrant. When I get some more tattoos, I'm going to get some, like, 12-volt tattoos. Because 3-volt, those flat nickel cell batteries, they're just not bright enough for me.
I know at one point purple was like outlawed
because of whatever was in it was poisonous.
And like Sailor Jerry and stuff, you couldn't like use purple.
Think about this though. How many fucking people in the world were getting a tattoo with purple in it that the government needed to come in and tell you can't have this, right? Because if the company had bribed the politicians, they'd have been all about like, oh, we recommend purple tattoos.
Yeah. If there was a lot of money to be made off of the purple, they would have just went ahead.
That's what I'm saying.
Let it go.
That's what I'm with you. That's what I'm saying. All right, let's get rid of some of these pals here. That one's correct there. This one's correct here. For you guys that don't know, that's a roll-up door there, and that's the wilderness out there. And this time of day, the sun is beating down on that. So it might be 80 degrees here, but it's 95 degrees back here.
1 foot away from your head.
Really? Yeah. I feel like I'm really about to fuck this up. Let's go. Just a barely a little bit down. Does that get concealed? It does not. Alright, we're going to set that one there, we're going to skip one, and then we're going to bury this one. Is that what we're doing? That is what we're doing.
Bury the term for attaching?
Well, I'm just going to put it under the edge. I'm going to sew over it. So I want just enough of this over there. Over yonder. I feel like there's a lot of noodling goes on in your town. You guys do a lot of noodling? Yeah. Mm-hmm. What is noodling?
Like catfishing?
Yeah, that's what I meant.
I've done it.
We're talking about with fish, right?
Yeah.
You caught a giant ass fish on your fist?
Yeah. Everybody goes like in ozone and stuff. Like
In ozone?
Yeah.
Where's ozone?
It's like where Ozone Falls is and stuff.
Oh.
It's all kinds of lakes and stuff just everywhere.
And we're talking about like catfish, like actual noodling. Fish in the water. We're not talking code for some weird shit.
Around in the mud.
Do they have...
They snap on.
They have teeth?
Yes.
Will they drown you?
No. I mean...
Has anybody ever drowned catfishing?
Probably. If you go to like Watch Bar. Look up Watch Bar Dam and look up the catfish.
Oh, yeah, like the man-sized fish and stuff. They say that about Lake Mead, too.
Yeah, Watch Bar is crazy. Like, there's all these stories of people hooking up trucks to, like, chains to pull out fish and stuff.
Really?
You gotta look at some of the pictures of it. It's crazy.
Okay, now I want this one just slightly down from the edge like I did that. This is my space. And I'm going to take this one right here. That's my stitch line. I'm gonna come right past there about a quarter inch. There's that tensioner piece that's broken on my machine. Pulled my thread through my needle. Man, you'd think I'd fix that.
It's easier just to work around now that you're used to it.
Is it? Is it easier? I mean, what would we have to talk about if it actually worked right?
I know.
I feel like I'm missing a couple of pieces of palace for this. Maybe not. Nope, there it is. Okay, now that I have those on, I know that these are opposites and I know that I've got them in the correct places. I have not built one of these in, I've not built one in this building, so at least 7 years I have not built one of these.
You've only been in this building 7 years?
I don't think I've been in this building even 7 years yet.
Crazy.
The first thing we did in this building right before we moved in is we had one of my birthday parties and Little White played here. So, I mean, we could find, that's how I figure out my timing as to when I moved in. I find that video and see when we posted that on YouTube. And that was kind of.
Had the bad influence in here himself, huh?
Came in like twacked out of his mind. And as soon as the fucking beat dropped, it's like he went clear-eyed all of a sudden, and just the fucking most amazing show
he just played
in the world.
He just played Kasky the other day.
Did he?
Yeah.
Good for him, man. Good. I'd like to see him do some shit, you know? Where were they at?
Well, it's in New Mexico.
Good.
I know for a while, didn't Lil White own a party rental company? Like for balloons for birthday parties and stuff?
Maybe, but I mean, he wasn't out like putting up jump houses.
I know, man.
And shit.
You should go his Instagram. I think at one point he was like delivering balloons for his own company because he couldn't get workers. And
oh,
stuff.
Fucking, yeah, maybe, man. Maybe. I remember he had a Escalade for sale and it was fucking so trashed. Oh my God, it was so trashed. I know I'm forgetting something here. Which way does this? All right, fuck it. We're building a split front chest rig. We'll go ahead and tell you that because I need to fucking measure where I put this shit. Okay, it's 1 inch down, 1 1/4 inch down, 1 1/4 inch down. We'll go with 1 1/4. That sounds good. You like 1 1/4?
I love 1 1/4.
1.25. Or 5/4. You like 5/4?
I like 5. Well, I don't like any quarters.
That's good, because they won't be long and they don't exist anymore.
Well, good, because
like
I don't earn any.
Like your U.S. dollars. You're going to be running Fed credits come June. The crazy thing is there's people on here like, what is he talking about?
All the tattoo artists are going to be in for a treat.
Tattoo artists. Fucking strippers.
Mechanics,
anybody, yeah. You want to pay the kid, you know, $20 to mow your grass or give your little brother a fucking birthday present, you're going to be paying taxes every time you move money.
I just sold some tickets on a ticket selling site for like a group that we'd bought tickets to that we didn't want to go to anymore. And if you make over six, if you sell over $600, they tax you on it.
They tax you, or they 1099 you and make you report?
I think they 1099 and make you report. Yeah. So I mean, I'd have to pay taxes on
that,
which is crazy because I've already paid taxes on it when I bought the ticket.
If you really wanted to solve the problem, just tax at the point of sale, right? So the business taxes and then they pay taxes. But they don't want that. They need you to be able to make a mistake so they can keep you in fear and then penalize you and have the fear of penalizing you. I think that I need these down yonder. I'm about to set these. Need to go on first. I'm tacking that like that. It doesn't need it.
If you don't X stitch everything, you're in trouble.
That's right. Because X is going to give it to you.
DMX theme today.
I was listening to DMX this morning. Message your rapper friend. What's his name? Chris. Supreme.
Oh.
Is it Lyric Supreme or Supreme Lyric?
Supreme Lyric.
Supreme Lyric.
His laptop, he just ran over it or something with all of his music on it?
No, I think one of his friends found it. Was it run over? I didn't catch that.
Yeah, he said it ran over in the water.
And he's got the worst luck. I'm like, I want to rap like Kevin Gates. He's like, right? I'm like, but you're going to teach me. I know I marked this. Yeah, there it is. It's in blue. That's why.
Switching up mark colors on me today.
Well, I pre-marked this because this is what we were going to build last week. I just wanted to have half of it, you know?
Yeah.
Kind of made, so I knew. It seems like this is really taking me a long time. So imagine what it would have been had I not pre-sewed a little bit of it last week, yeah.
I think if you're watching these, what you should be taking out of these is the small little things, the details you're doing. Not necessarily what you're building constantly.
Yeah, because it's not, the guys are like, well, you should build this thing. Like, you don't see enough in these videos to be able to actually build it, you know?
And that's not on purpose. Yeah. Sitting here.
Yeah, we wouldn't be in the fucking dark if we were trying to teach you how to build it. But there's something in here for everyone. Like, you could watch. You could be sewing shit for 10 years, and you're going to watch these, and every one of them, there's some piece
small
in there.
Piece.
Yeah, no matter how good you are. Can you still go over Niagara Falls in a barrel?
I think so. A lot of people commit suicide there, so
because they just get whipped under the current.
Yeah, I think they just jump in from the rail right there. It's not like, I don't think there's like guards watching. They just, there's a handrail. Doesn't seem like the way I'd want to go though. It's like jumping off the bridge. Is it the San Francisco Bridge or whatever? It's like people still survive.
Yeah, it's like hitting concrete. They say there's victims. Like there's people who have jumped off that now tell their story. You know,
yeah,
like I regretted it halfway down.
Yeah. Where it's like one guy, like he was going to, then he decided not to, but then he slipped.
Slipped, yeah. Or you survive it, and you're like, okay, oh man, I'm good, and then a shark bites your leg off. I think there's sharks there, right?
I think so.
I just punched the shark in his nose.
Isn't that what they teach you?
Yeah, I mean, that's what I teach. I teach punch the shark in the nose. Probably
gouge for the eye.
What are you in for? Punch the shark in the nose. Federal crime. Wildlife Jurisdictional Task Force. Most dangerous animal in the world. I'm very discombobulated here. Oh yeah, I already fucked that up. That's supposed to be on that side, not this side. How about this one? Yeah, a little bit backwards, or a lot. All right, well, I know we need grommets, and I'm gonna cut another piece of Velcro. This one's special, so we're gonna charge $25 more because it has this extra piece of Velcro on the wrong side. Anyways. What do we want the spread on this to be? These are 308 mags. They don't need to be skinny. I'd rather have my bungees. Where the fuck is that ruler at? There it is. I'd rather have my bungees spread out a little bit. So I'm going to make my spread 1 inch. So the center of 3 is 1.5 inches. I'm going to make at 1 inch and 2 inches. And then the same here. And I'm going to put grommets in here. And you guys at home, you're going to put your grommets in the really hard way. Not really. You can buy a hand setter. We did it for literally a decade, probably. Maybe even longer. I didn't have a kick press. Buy yourself a kick press. If you're going to put in more than a couple hundred grommets a year or snaps, get a kick press set. What's a kick press? I'm glad you asked. Come on, I'll show you. How long is this? It doesn't fucking matter. That's how long it is. Just hold this next to it and cut a piece that's the same size. You don't need to measure it. You don't need a tape measure. You don't need a ruler. This is a kick press. You call it a kick press because you do this like you're kicking. So I'm going to set this right here. I'm going to go ahead and put that down there. Is that about where I want it? Yes, it is. Wow, right. Check that out. Perfect. I don't even know how that happened. Same thing, pretty close. Pa-dow. So, I think the washer goes on the bottom. The washer, then this thing, which one do we want? This is the inside or the outside? That's the inside, so we're going to go just like this. Perfect. Don't catch any of you in this, because whatever you catch in here, it'll cut it off. Tip of your finger, tip of your finger.
Tip of your wiener.
Tip of your winger. You will tell us what we want to know.
I pierce ears with this? Pierce arms with this?
You could pierce this much with it for sure. It will. It'll cut the meat right out of there.
I used to think that those were just called Vice Grips, and that wasn't the company.
Oh yeah, Vice Grips is a company. Irwin, doesn't Irwin own Vice Grip? Maybe not.
I don't know.
They make one of these that's air operated. So you just put it in there and it goes, psh, does it all. It'll pierce it. You can also get piercing grommets. You can get grommets that are sharpened. It'll punch through so you don't have to punch the hole first. It'll actually do all of it all in one motion. We don't do it. I like to do everything the hard way.
What to say? It just seems lazy.
Yeah. It's probably for fat guys.
Your body fat's way too low to be using
my body fat machine. My body fat is way too, all this vascularity, that's why, because I do this. I don't even have, I don't have to do legs.
No leg day, it's just kick day.
Yeah, I don't even squat, bro. I don't even have to ruck. I just pay Bear and he rucks. And it gives me part of the rucking points. The rucking cred, the street cred for rucking. It's like a ruckus.
Honda ruckus?
I don't have a Honda ruckus. I got a Grom.
I want a Honda ruckus.
I think you should have one. I think that's what you should ride here.
Hops out at 40. Well, it says 45, but it really is about 40 or 35.
When we start our gang.
So.
It'd be a ruckus gang.
35 miles an hour.
When society collapses.
10 hours probably.
When society collapses, that's what we will control our territory with Honda ruckuses. And if there was a bunch of them, it'd be ruckusai, like hippopotami.
I think we should just go to Nashville and get those electronic scooters.
They fucking leave them everywhere.
Yeah.
We call those guys the bird catchers. The guys that pick them up?
Yeah.
Those are bird catchers, in case you didn't know. I have a feeling I shouldn't be putting this on yet, but let's go ahead and do it anyway. See what happens.
This might be a very special rig for someone.
Yeah. Yeah. Might be.
I blame it on the heat.
Yes. It's made my brain not work right.
Could also be all the DMX.
I'm gonna have to do extra cold plunge tomorrow. How we should do our next podcast. We'll do it like from ice baths. See who gets out first.
I would absolutely love that. Wait, I don't have to film in it, do I?
Ice at us, yeah. Me, you, Scully.
Okay.
Yeah, you gotta be in the ice bath. Come on. Not the same one. I'll get you your own ice bath.
No. I wanna be in the same one.
You wanna be in the pee water?
Yeah, I wanna be in you and Jeff, all the same one.
In the YMCA public pool. Yeah, that's not chlorine you're smelling. It's all the ammonia. I wonder if pool chemicals have changed since you were a kid. Remember how you used to go to a public pool? You ever go to an indoor pool?
Yeah.
and how strong that smell was.
So bad.
Imagine all the shit that they used to kill us with. Imagine what was in the water when we were kids.
They used to have these fiberglass filters on the side of our public pool.
You mean asbestos?
Like, yeah, it's like these crazy, and like you would always have to get out of the side of it. If you're a kid, you'd love to jump out really quick. So we put our hands on it. At the end of the day, our whole hands were covered in it, and it's like you couldn't touch anything. It hurt so bad. So I probably just...
I need that piece of Velcro, I forgot.
I'm made of asbestos now.
They're building stacked mag micros. These are split front 308 micros right here. Do you remember the cell phone with the chip?
With the chip?
Yeah. You could buy cell phones that were jailbroke, so you didn't have to pay for cell service. You didn't have that when you were a kid?
Mm-mm.
When I was a kid, we didn't even have cell phones.
Well, my friend had a car phone that is mine.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it went on like a big clunk thing, yeah, with a leather pouch.
And... we were in Fashion Valley Mall, me and my friend Mike, and this dude ran up all excited because he had a phone and Mike had a phone. He's like, I'll walk to the other end of the mall, and what's your number, and I'll call you.
I got, the first one I ever got was a Razor.
Yeah, the
like
flip.
The Motorola.
Yeah, I bought Amanda a lot of those. That's a good chick
and,
phone. Totally see why you chose that.
Yeah, and then I had one of the G-Zone Nokia, like it goes underwater, you know, like the
okay,
waterproof
yeah.
ones. I love them.
So I liked the little brick ones that you talked on like a phone, but then it opened up and it had a full keyboard. It was the first one that ever had a keyboard, I think, a real one.
It wasn't the Sidekick. It was because that was Motorola.
Yeah, it wasn't Sidekick. I think it was Samsung.
It wasn't a BlackBerry.
No, I never had a BlackBerry, I don't think.
I know exactly which one you're talking about.
The CrackBerry.
Do you think you've done all this right, though?
If it's not, I'm not going to admit to it, and they're not going to know. No, I did it. I did it right. It'll still function, even if I didn't. You know why this is the right way to do it? Because it's the way I did it the first time. Like, there's not... it doesn't matter if it's wrong, if it works. I'm using these giant fucking scissors because my fingers will fit in them. The smaller scissors, even though it's the same model, same brand, I hit reorder on the same link. They've added this stupid fucking hump in here. They didn't used to have this thing. And this hump's not as bad as the other scissors. There's a pair of scissors I use that's way lighter. And my fucking, I have to like pull it off of my fingers.
I need some of those orange giant ones they use in school. All the teachers have that I could never find.
The safety scissors?
Yeah. Or get some meat cutting scissors because the openings on both sides are huge.
I'm just going to hire a midget that sits here and cuts what I need cut.
Cuts everything.
Yeah. A hot midget. I have one. Never mind. He's just busy right now.
Is there a height requirement when it comes to getting like assistance for that?
Assistance? I don't know, but Amanda can definitely tell you because she's 1 inch over being a midget.
How tall is she?
I don't know how tall she is.
My stepmom's 4'10".
I'm like, Amanda's 4 foot. She's like, I'm not fucking 4 foot. 4'10"? Yeah, yeah. I don't know. Ask her. I'm sure she knows how tall she is. It's like a chihuahua, right? It's this cute little thing, but it's definitely going to bite somebody. It's probably going to get you in a fight.
Yep.
Something's going to happen. Oh, something's not right here, too. Imagine that. I need another piece of Velcro. That's how they all come now, with two pieces of Velcro. That's what happens when I talk. Why do I have extra oh, that goes up here. These extra pals here. Which way do we want to put the buckles? Let's put this on one thing though. I'll be right back.
You need to listen to more DMX.
I listen to a lot of DMX this morning.
You need to listen to more all the time. A little so they can see.
I was sewing fast because I know it's crooked and I didn't want them to see that I put this on crooked. See, it's crooked. It's not really crooked. Maybe it is. Okay. I have a lot of this. I'm not sure what these are. I bet they're pull tabs. And this, I don't know what these are. I do. I know what they are. Okay, two, see, I can't see the green ruler because this fucking green light you have set back here. Does it matter if you're insane, if you're super famous?
I don't know.
Can you really be super famous and not be insane?
I was about to say, I don't think you can be very successful and not be a little.
I'm going for like, I want him to compare me to like Howard Hughes. I think that's a good. Saves all my toenails.
Yeah.
Keep my pee in jars.
I save all my dog's toenails, whiskers, and everything.
Do you really?
Yep, I've got jars of them.
Why?
His teeth, all of his baby teeth.
If I could buy a 5 gallon, if I could buy a 5 gallon Sparklets bottle, full of toenails, I would buy that. I think
I can start saving you my toenails.
I would totally put them in a 5, but it can't be a bullshit Sparklets bottle. It's got to be like an original glass one. Because I have a 5 gallon Sparklets jar full of human teeth.
I can get you my toenails full of them.
I think toenails would be good.
No, my cat too, before, like, I just saved every single whisker.
I'm going to tack this in so I don't have to, well, no, I'm not.
Now that he's passed away, I go in there every once in a while and I go, look at that whisker.
Do you have his skeleton?
No.
I'm having all my dogs from now on. I don't know that I've had a dog pass. They usually, something happens to them before they die, you know? Like they run away or something. Yeah. But I'm going to keep all their skeletons. Is this the front? This is the front. Anybody want to tell me why I'm putting this on the front of the panel and not the back of the panel? Anybody want to tell me why I just did an X instead of a Z? I did the X instead of a Z to show you I could do the X to flex on you. The buckle's on the front of the panel, because if it's on the back of the panel would fall open. You can't have that. You can't have your shit dangling around. That's why. So that goes there. And then this looks like this goes to the top corner. So. This one's there, this one's going to go here. It doesn't matter if it's the front or the back because we're going to sew it on the edge here. So on this one, I just went like this, right? But this one, I'm going to do it this way so it's flatter. Why? I don't know why. I don't have a good reason for it because I said so. Come up here to the corner. Yes. That was my question mark inflection. Corner in there. Do you think anybody's growing up right now and they're like, I want to become a coroner? I think those are probably weirdos.
Yeah.
They want to touch.
My friend is.
They want to touch naked girls.
Cremated our cat and stuff. And
naked dead girls. What?
My friend cremated our cat, and he owns a cremation business in our town. He does all the cremation for animals and all the dead bodies in our town.
Can I have the extra parts?
Talk to them.
I mean, they have extra parts, right?
Yeah,
I'm pretty
sure
like the hip replacements and shit. I've seen those. Those don't melt. right? Yeah, that looks right. Looks perfect.
So far, so good.
The rest will be too.
We don't warn anybody about getting their fingers cut off anymore by the thread, because we just think at this point, if you're already 12 in and you haven't...
You would think. However, one of my top G out there, she cut the shit out of her. Actually, I saw her putting Band-Aids or something. I go, what are you doing? So I cut my finger on the thread. I'm like, when you were pulling it through? She's like, yeah. And she's been sewing for a long time. She came here sewing. I don't think we taught her. So I'm like, told you so.
Should have watched the video.
Does it hurt? Oh, it hurts? Just slam your other finger in the drawer. Take your mind right off of this. Gonna feel a little pressure.
Major pain?
Yeah. Clicking language.
Clicking your teeth at me?
Don't suck your teeth at me, man. All the stupid shit I say. Some people are laughing and other people are like, what the fuck is he talking about? If you don't know, I don't think we can be friends.
Yeah, I was about to say, I don't think we can be around if they don't know.
If they don't know, they've probably got that coexist sticker. I don't even know what that means. What does it mean?
I have no clue. Is it a company or is it like just a...
No, I think it's like
is it like an animal rights thing?
I think it's like a... Maybe? I think it's like a...
Coexist with animals?
No, I think it's like one of them chicks with a dick. I think that's like the secret handshake.
I'm about to...
Find out. You're about to Google chicks with dicks?
Well, I did that the other day.
So it's already just going to be in there?
Yeah.
Okay. Don't want the female or the male buckle, right? The male, that's the penis side, goes into the girl side, that's the female side. And because I'm right-handed, and right-handed people rule the world, it's always...
They shoot very well.
He says that all the time, right? He shoots really fast because he doesn't have to come off the trigger on a bolt gun, right? He still shoots that hand. No, this, you know what I'm saying. Being a sniper is not about being able to shoot the gun. It's more about math, right?
Yeah.
Because I was on the ranges. I was on many, many ranges where I got behind his rifle and shot 975 and 1000 and hit steel all the time, right? Because he did the work. It's the math. It's the math. So, I mean, pretty much, like, you've got your certificate, you're a certified gunsman now.
Yeah.
I mean, clearly I'm a sniper.
He didn't even bring my shirt today.
Your shirt?
Thought he had a... Are you gonna make a shirt that says SOE certified gunsman?
You want me to? We'll make one.
Totally, we'll do it.
Certified dope. Oh, we should totally do that. I'll bet somebody's done that, though. So... Like when you're dialing in your mouth and shit, that's all your dope, right? On your rifle, your dope. But you know from rap, like certified dope, we should do that, but have it be all your math from the reticle and everything.
I was thinking a silhouette outline of me holding a gun with, it says gunsman, certified.
A high point?
Yeah.
You know that motherfucker just bought a high point? That's where he's going. He's going today, right now, to pick up a high point, and they custom painted it for him. Like real Cerakote with American flag.
Perfect.
perfect. The best. Believe it. Everyone tells me.
Is that how you're supposed to hold that?
Yes. That's my third hand.
Gotcha.
For most good girls, that's the third input. Or for some of you weirdos, too, probably.
Figure that makes this rig cost a little bit more. I don't know.
They're gonna try to clone me, and then they won't need me anymore to do these videos. We're gonna turn on YouTube one day, and we're gonna see episode like 18, 19, and 20. And we haven't even filmed 13. What are we filming right now?
I think this is
13. 13. 38. 11, 12, 13.
Do you have to speak Spanish at this point in like California, like lower California?
Do you have to? I don't know. I haven't been in that motherfucker in a decade.
Like, I'm just saying, like, when I even...
You mean when they pull me back into court, am I going to have to know Spanish to talk to the judge?
I went to Miami and it was hard for me to, like, because it's like...
Come on, I know you weren't in Miami long because you didn't say Miami.
No.
I've seen it on Miami Vice.
I was there and I was like, man, I'm hungry, but I'm absolutely terrible at trying to read Spanish.
Where?
In Miami.
That's Cuban, buddy. That's not even Spanish. That's not real Spanish.
Well.
You got to get with my boy, the white shark, Tiburon Blanco, because he's from Miami. He's probably going to be like, hey, fuckhead. That's not how it's really said. This is a dude that, I don't even know if I should be saying this. I don't know how he got here, but he's a U.S. citizen. And these motherfuckers that weren't born in the United States know everything about the United States, right? Like, when we take a dude from another country and he gets a citizenship, freedom, right? Do whatever you want to do, but that's who should be teaching our history classes. People not from here, because they give a fuck about our history. It was important enough for them to do whatever it took to get here, and they learned everything about here. And most of us don't know shit about our own country, but these guys do. And that's what, when I say that's what stands out. Like, that guy just stood here and fucking schooled me on the Constitution and, like, just everything, you know, America. So, if you need to get a, order a real Cuban sandwich next time you're there, let me know. Also, I got a t-shirt place over there. And when you see the place, it looks like Cuba. Like, it's all like corrugated metal, like this place used to be in here, all that ugly green corrugated metal, and there's like wild chickens running around, but they don't look like normal chickens because they're like game cocks. That's the place, that's one of the t-shirt places we used to use over there. Great quality work, great service. Just looks like Cuba, which is cool. I mean, I like Cuba. I saw it in Fast and Furious. Did I just fuck this up? I'm about to fuck it up. Here we go. What's the, is the new, you know there's a new Fast and Furious, right?
I have no clue. I stopped after two.
I think it's like 27 or 28.
I don't know. I think I stopped when the Tokyo Drift.
So oh shit, that was a horrible one. That was what, number two?
That was the second and third. I don't know. I know I saw the first one.
I just like to get all my my combative skills from the movie. I like to just, it's a good kind of catch up on what's new out there. All my ninja skills.
hard for me to enjoy a lot of action movies now after being on the range with like special force dudes constantly for because the last like, 5 years.
Because you almost die every time.
Yeah, well, I'm just
you
I'm
have
watching,
flashbacks.
Yeah, I'm watching movies. I'm like, that is so wrong. I was like, what is he doing?
Yeah. I've already fucked this up twice. Go ahead and not make that mistake here. Probably too late. Let's go ahead and just open this up rather than fight this. Watch. So I'm going to Arkansas in 2 weeks. We are going to Arkansas in August.
What's in Arkansas?
We're going to do some ninja classes.
Ninja classes? Like Ninja Warrior?
No, ninja. Like ninja. Ninja.
Oh, ninja.
Like smoke screens and throwing bombs and stuff. Split toe shoes. So are you down? Count you in?
For Arkansas?
Yeah.
Where is Arkansas?
That way?
I'm in if it's right there.
So
I get to wear webbed toe shoes.
Four and a half hours.
From here?
Yeah. I'll hire a driver.
Perfect.
I like it. I'm just going to start hiring drivers. I'm not even going to have them take me anywhere.
I figure at this point you would have a driver to take if you're going like looking at antiques.
I just feel bad. But I saw Bob was like, hey, I need a driver for these dates. You'll be driving one of my vehicles. I don't know what he's doing that he needs a driver, but I thought it sounded like a fucking great idea if I could just have a driver. I mean, Amanda drives everywhere, so if we could go places and she didn't have to drive, then she'd be like, that's too far, I don't want to drive there. And I could just totally disarm her and be like, you can just sleep.
You don't have to drive.
Plus, I want a limo. And she's like, I'm not driving a fucking limo. So we'll get a limo or a limo bus, and then we'll get a driver.
Do you see a bunch of limos running around your town the other day from prom?
I'm never around in town. If they might have been here, but I wouldn't have seen them. Like when I leave this property, I usually leave town. I don't. And the only reason I drive through town is because I don't have a tunnel to out of town. That's why they're going to be so surprised when I get elected mayor.
I just have one train only for you?
No, they won't know. They're like, who is this guy? We've never seen him. Get with my CIA contacts and have them install me as the dictator.
Over Camden?
Yeah, I'm not really going to dictate a lot, but...
You're going to fix that bad Burger King though, aren't you?
I don't know. I haven't been to Burger King in fucking years, man. I am of the belief that if it has a drive-thru window, they are poisoning you.
Good. Casey's doesn't have a drive-thru.
Okay.
So their pizza is not poisonous.
I will buy a Casey's. And all we'll use it for is to make pizza for you.
Perfect.
Does that sound like a good idea?
Perfect. Sounds perfect.
Man, I really feel like I'm forgetting something here. You have really made this build take a lot extra time. You ever have your tire just go flat?
Yeah.
Like, just flat, right?
Mm-hmm.
How'd the air get out of it?
Weather, usually.
The weather let the air out
drastic
of your tire?
Drastic cold causing the pressure or whatever.
Is that much pressure? Like, flat. I mean flat. Like, flat on the rim.
I would assume that you'd probably already had something wrong with your rim.
Right. Like, you got a puncture or something. Like, I'm driving the four-wheeler around Sunday, all around the property doing stuff, you know, moving feed, and I'm clipping a bunch of trees and shit. And then I go to come back to the building, and it's just all mushy, right? So the tire's flat, like on the rim. So I'm like, okay, I ran over something. So I pull it in, pull the wheel off, pump it up. I got the wheel off because I know I'm gonna have to plug it. I'm just see what's up with it. And there's nothing. It's not leaked. Like, you should hear it pissing. Psst, nothing. Find a couple spots, maybe put some spit on there, not bubbling. Fill it back up, put the wheel back on. It's been full all week. I don't know how the fucking tire got flat. I mean, completely flat.
I wonder if you just hit like a rock and it pushed it in, or
I don't know what did it, man. I don't know.
I hit a pothole in Nashville so hard one time that I had to buy a new rim.
We hit a pothole in the Range Rover on the way to the NRA show in Indiana, I think, is where we were going. That or Blade Show. And it cracked the wheel on the Range Rover in three pieces. That's when I bought those new wheels. Almost at the end of the build and you're closing this rig up and you're going through four layers of Cordura here and four here and two layers of edge tape, so eight layers of Cordura. This is bulky. Take your time at the end because you're in a hurry and you're like, I'm glad this is over. We've done this. It's accomplished. It's done. Just take your time. That extra couple of seconds right there is going to save you breaking that sewing machine. And this too, I've done this too, right? Both of these need to go in here, but you miss, and one's on the inside, one's on the outside. It would totally function. It just looks really shitty, and you couldn't send that to a customer like that. It does. See this extra piece? It's probably not good. It goes right there. There's that. All good in the hood. I've lost at least, I don't know, 3% body fat probably sitting here. So I'm probably at like close to 2%, maybe 3%
maybe
body fat right now. Maybe
1. 1.9?
Maybe 1. Which side is that sewn to? Sewn to that side. So if we open this side, it'll be a lot less bulk to cut through. Take your time. This whole thing's all the way together, and this is where I'm going to nick this, and this whole rig will be trash at that point. Pull, cut the thread. Pull, cut the thread. We're pulling to expose a couple of threads. Couple stitches, right? Watch that razor blade. You can nick that and cut through all of that material. You could totally just sew through it and put it back together, but if it's really going to a customer, you can't. All this bullshit right here, cut that out of there. When you sew it, it's going to pull it back through and it's going to look like a rat's nest. what should have happened is this should have been sewn here and here, and then this, once this was closed, we would sew through all of that bulk, but we're just going to do it the back way and then sew through the panel, close it up. You picking up what I'm putting down?
Picking it up.
I think this, yeah. See, I'm about to sew that in the wrong place because I actually had that space down a quarter inch. But you caught that from the beginning. I know all of you guys were like, hey, 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 hey. Wrong position. Did you ever have vocal training?
No.
You just like decided you're going to be the lead singer of a band?
Well, I was drumming all the time and I would do backing vocals and just the harmonies. And then one day our singer quit, and then we got another singer, then we got rid of him, and then we were going to get another singer and we were like, you know what?
What does get rid of look like? Like, we just lost him at the bus stop, drove away, left him there. What is got rid of?
Got rid of is finding out that he was a terrible person and getting rid of him.
Was he a good drummer? Or vocal? Was he a vocal? We're talking about vocals.
Yeah, he was a great vocalist.
So he was auto-tuning? You found out he was auto-tuning? No? Something worse than that?
Yeah, way worse. But, no, one day I was just like, hey, maybe I'll try. And I wasn't very good at the very start. But practice for like years.
You get a voice coach?
No. Just sitting around trying to imitate my favorite artists.
Did you Google how to rap?
I did not.
Do you have any satanic tattoos?
What do you consider satanic?
I feel like if you had them, you would know.
Really? I don't know. I do. Are skulls satanic?
I guess it depends.
I have a devil on the back of my neck.
A devil?
Yeah. It's like our band's logo, the Red Spectre.
The Red Spectre. Isn't a spectre a ghost?
Yeah. But he had little devil horns. It was the first film ever made in color.
Was it a movie called The Red Spectre?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
They found the only copy of it in the back of a trunk in a car in a junkyard in Mexico.
Really?
Yep. In the can.
Why was it there?
I had no clue. I don't know the entire backstory of it, but it was a lost film from 1908.
I feel like we should make some movies and just tell people that they're lost films.
For sure.
Okay, these are pull tabs. You don't have to make yours this way, but I do these this way. I'm gonna leave a channel. You don't want a lot of channel there that it's loose, but you don't want it so tight that you have to fight to get the two layers of bungee through there. So, I'm gonna make this one right here. Now this works on the 308. This will not work on AK, at least not well. All your 308 mags, none of them are rocked or canted like the AK mags. So we just build these this way. You can do all of your split if you want, like we do on our 5.56 mags, because as a byproduct, they'll work for AK mags. But you do you, whatever that is. It means that I'm only doing four. I'm not going to mark these. I'm just going to build them off of each other. You're doing a bunch of them. They'll transition and change, and there'll be a drastic change between the first and the last. But four, you can probably get away with not making marks. feels like that channel. I'm gonna fight to get that bungee through there. So basically, I'm just folding this in half right here, meeting in the middle or close to the middle. All right, and then I'm gonna pull these out a little bit. Here's that third hand thing. I'm gonna use that presser foot. I'm gonna hold this, and now I'm gonna pull on these. Stretches them out, gives you room to get the scissor blades through there. It also tightens those stitches up. While I have this in my hand, we might as well go ahead and clean up these. Now, I'm gonna fold these down here. Now this is four, five, this is eight layers of material right here, so take your time on these. I'm actually gonna lift my foot all the way up, and I'm gonna get my needle kind of down there, right? And now I'm just gonna push it through by hand and kind of start it and thumb it through here. So I'm kind of got the motor starting to break free and move, but I'm just catching on that little burr on the bottom of the foot there. Now, the next one I'll just roll straight into, and it should transition across easier than starting it flat-ish. My sewing machine is moving, so I don't have the wheels locked. Those are casters.
Casters.
Toolman Tim was here from Canada. Today. And they call things different things. Like, it's not an oil field, it's an oil patch. I worked at the oil patch instead of the oil fields, you know. He had another word instead of gutters on the building. He had another word for that. I don't remember what it was, but for you weirdos that don't know what wheels are. You know breakdance fighting?
No.
You don't know breakdance fighting?
No.
Have you seen Zoolander?
Like 5 minutes of it when it first came out?
I'm gonna need you to watch that.
Okay.
I'll buy it for you. Okay. Here's my tool tabs. Someplace here. Here. Wow, there it is.
I've seen Demolition Man.
Demolition Man?
It's my favorite movie of all
time.
Taco
Bill? That's how we're kind of turning, right?
Yeah.
Taco Bell sponsors our government.
Which I was pretty excited about their world. I
mean, you normal people are going to live in the gutters and live in the sewer and eat rats.
Rat burgers.
Rat burgers. I've Googled many, many hours. I've scoured the internet, and I still don't know how to use the three seashells.
I don't think we'll ever know.
Okay, so there's the bungee. Get it half. Push this out. Get this through here. All right. There's that. And I'm just going to tie this through here. You don't have to tie this to the front. You can tie yours through the grommets and conceal your little knot. But I'm going to put mine here. I'm going to pull that pretty short, and then we're going to tighten it. And there it is. for all you little guys that didn't have a girlfriend all through high school and you, you know, made paracord bracelets and shit. I'm sure you know plenty of macrame. So you can tie whatever fancy knot it is you're into.
Remember when hemp bracelets and stuff were a big thing?
No.
And hemp necklaces?
No.
You're from California, though.
What does that mean?
That means it's always a big thing there, right? Hemp?
No.
More hippies over there?
No. I know kids, like, a while ago, everybody was wearing, like, puka shells or...
Yeah.
You know, shells and shit.
When I was, like, 14.
And now it's, like... If you see it in antique stores, right? You'll see pieces of coral and seashells and shit, and a lot of them are very, very expensive. But when I was a kid, we had Seashell World. Like, really, it was no bullshit. Down by the sports arena, there was a building. Shit, it had to be bigger than this, right? This is 10,000 feet, and all that was in there was shells and coral, and it smelled like dead ocean animals because it was, you know. But even at, like, SeaWorld had a shell shop where you could buy, and now it's, like, this taboo thing to take anything from the ocean.
Rachel doesn't like you taking rocks and skipping them.
Well, why?
Into lakes.
Oh, I love it.
Because she's like,
I think we'd start
all the rock goes there, and you're throwing it into the lake there.
It goes there like some other asshole kid didn't fucking throw it there to begin with.
Well, I think I'm trying to find the best rocks. Flat rocks from the garden beds and stuff that they put them there.
Oh, got it.
That are like slick and almost like marble-like from our park.
Yeah,
I'm taking bags of them down there.
We used to go to Seaport Village where they've like, I don't know how much of it they made, but it's like a bay area kind of, right? But the whole shoreline is covered in riprap, right? Big cement blocks and stuff to keep it from eroding and eating up more of the land. So as kids, we were always over there throwing all that shit and turning it over looking for crabs and seashells and shit. We probably did a lot of damage looking back at it. Now that I have actually bought gravel and riprap, we put fucking thousands of dollars of that shit down in the water.
Stink bug in here.
Yeah, they say don't kill those. When you crush them, it releases the pheromones.
That'd be a good cologne for us.
Stink bug cologne?
Pheromones of a stink bug?
Pheromones. You get attacked. What ended him? He was bombarded by stink bugs. Okay, so there's that.
There's the rig.
I'll show you how we make the shoulder straps. I think I showed you this once before. Are you B-rolling that right now? Or
no, you're good.
Get that out of the way. Okay. This is how we're going to do this. You're going to do it this way because it's how I do it this way. You can do it a different way so that you can be different, but this way's the best pretty much. Nobody ever did this. I invented this. It didn't exist. Okay, check it out. I don't know what the measurement is. It looks like it's 3 inches from here to here, but you do you, boo-boo. I'm going to take this, and I'm going to sew this captive. Yours could totally be like this if you want. It will work just the same. But I'm going to sew it this way so it's a little cleaner. It's concealed, that raw edge. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. And I'm going to zigzag over here. Go 1, 2, 3. I need to find the guy that used to do the Dracula voice for Sesame Street.
One.
Count Dracula. Yeah, that's it. There's some guy on Instagram has a sew company. I don't know where he's at. I think he's in like New England or somewhere. And if you look at his bio, it says he's the first person to ever use a plastic side release buckle on luggage. Maybe. I don't know.
Maybe.
But I've been doing this 35 years, or well, probably more now than 35, but I just found him a year ago, so maybe. Does it matter, I guess, is the real question, right?
Yeah, if that's your, you can say whatever you
if
want.
If that's though. Your claim to fame, and I mean, they might do awesome work, I don't know. I actually reached out to them, and I never heard back from them. But if that's the thing you're most proud of, and that's your current day catch line for your bio, you probably need to do some other shit. Like if the thing you're most impressed of was more than 90 days ago, the thing that impresses you the most about your career, if it's more than 90 days ago, you probably need to revamp that. Thread. What did I say? Two more? I think this is the...
Yeah.
You can adjust your winder. Come over here, I'll show you. This screw right here, if you don't know what this is. This adjusts your winder on your thread. It bends it back or lets it forward. See how it's moving? Do you see it? What I'm talking about?
Okay, yeah.
So that catches when the thread gets filled to that point, it pushes this out. So I can make the winder hold more thread. But some sewing machines, if you have more thread in there, you'll fight it. It'll actually do weird shit to your tension and it'll backlash in there. So some sewing machines are actually better off just changing your thread more frequently. And a good mechanic can fix that for you, but most people don't have a good mechanic, and they themselves are not a good mechanic. So is it worth fighting the fight, or is it worth just changing the thread a little more frequently? You're going to have to decide that.
So the first thing I ever learned from this is how to change thread fast, and your bobbin and rethread needle.
Yeah, get
Do
good.
All those fast.
Get good at threading the needle. You can tell somebody... who didn't have money, right? Because they had a beat machine. Because beat machines, you know, beat up machines, old used high mileage machines, they're missing, they always have some little broken part. I have parts on sewing machines today that I didn't even know existed for a sewing machine and were supposed to be there until just a decade ago. So look at all that thread right there. That's where I was running low, and it kind of backlashed and sucked all that out of there. And cutting it off like this, that's not the real way to fix it. The real way to fix it is to unstitch that and get all that rat nest out of there. Don't look at that side. That little guy, don't worry about that.
Extra thread.
Look at that side, yeah. That's extra thread. You might have to use it to catch fish with later. When you're jumping over Germany in the middle of the night and you get blown off course and you have to E&E and survive on your own.
And you haven't ever noodled before.
Right, because they're trying to capture you and take you to Castle Wolfenstein. I know somebody's like, oh, John plays video games. Nope, I saw a movie that was based on a video game. I've never played a fucking video game.
Not even Tony Hawk Pro Skater? Because it's the only video game you should play.
I actually know Tony Hawk, and I've never played his fucking video game. You know why? Because I have girls instead of played video games.